Welcome back. In this video, we'll be discussing the bacterial genetics, and we'll talk about transformation, transposition, transduction, and conjugation. We'll learn their meanings and how to differentiate between them. So first, let's talk about transposition. The bacteria has its DNA in two parts, either the bacterial chromosome or the bacterial plasmid. The bacterial chromosome is much larger and more complex and contains most of the bacterial DNA. And the bacterial plasmid is a small part of the bacterial DNA that has left the chromosome and now is floating inside the bacteria. So transposition refers to the process of extracting a small part of the bacterial chromosome to become plasmid or reintegrating the plasmid into the bacterial chromosome. Keep in mind that if the bacteria want to share its DNA with another bacteria, it can only share its plasmid, not the chromosomes. So the plasmid is smaller and readily accessible. Just remember that transposition has to do with plasmid. Now let's talk about conjugation. So some bacteria have a sex palace and we call these bacteria F positive, and other bacteria don't have these sex palates and we call this F negative. Keep in mind that the sex palace is encoded by the bacterial plasmid, not the bacterial chromosome. So the F positive bacteria will link with the F negative bacteria and form the mating bridge. Then the F positive bacteria will make a copy of its plasmid, which encodes for the bacterial sex palace, and will transfer this copy to the other bacteria. So now both bacteria have a plasmid which encodes for a sex palace, and both are called F positive. This is the process of conjugation. Transformation, which is also known as competence, is the ability of the bacteria to take naked genomes or naked DNA from the environment and use this DNA. So for example, if we have some medium with some bacteria in it and we put some raw naked DNA, which encodes for antibiotic resistance, into this medium as well, this bacteria will be able to take this DNA from the environment and use it, and it will become antibiotic resistance. However, if we add a DNA lysing agent into the environment, it will degrade the DNA and the bacteria will not be able to use it. We see this exclusively in Streptococcus pneumonia, H influenza, and Neisseria. So remember, transformation for fresh DNA. And finally, transduction refers to the process where a bacteriophage, which is a bacterial virus carrying its own DNA, will inject this DNA into the bacteria. This viral DNA will be integrated into the bacterial DNA and will start replicating the virus. If this results in a bacterial death, we call this a lytic phage. And if it didn't, we call this a lysogenic phage. If the bacteriophage did not kill the bacteria, aka a lysogenic phage, it will give the bacteria some superpowers, so the bacteria now can produce exotoxins. Alright guys, that's everything for today. I tried to explain everything as much as I could. Hopefully I made this easier for you, and see you guys later.